Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to interact and learn together. We are going to have our biology from 3 lesson 6, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerard. We are going to handle the topic on classification 2 under the subtopic class Arachnida. Remember, we have got several classes under the Kingdom Animalia, but now in this lesson we are going to look at class Arachnida. But before we get deep into it, we now have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, we should be able to give the characteristics of both arachnids and insects, and you are welcome. Now let us look at the class Arachnida, whereby this actually it includes, let us look at a grammatic representation of its examples, whereby we can have the scorpion, we have the spider, and we also have the mite. I am going to give the general characteristics of this class as we are observing now the characteristics on our diagrammatic representation, which is on our screen. The first characteristic is that the body has two parts, that is the cephalothorax and the abdomen. What I mean by a cephalothorax, I mean that the head and the thorax, they are joined together. So it might be difficult for you to differentiate them. That is why we are referring to it as cephalothorax. Our second characteristic is that the cephalothorax consists of a fused head and thorax. The third is that the ventral side of the cephalothorax has two chelicerae, each having a claw-like structure, which produce poison and paralyzes the prey. If you look at the either of the scorpion or the spider, you actually on the ventral view, we can see the chelicerae. These ones, its function, it produces a poison, whereby it will paralyze its prey. Actually, they are very dangerous. The fourth characteristic is that the cephalothorax has four pair of walking legs, each having several points, as you can see from our diagram. Each leg ends in two toothed claws. If you observe very closely, each pair, that is each leg, it ends in two toothed claws. Another characteristic is that arachnids have no antennae. They have a short pair of pedipalps, which are short, jointed, and look like legs. The pedipalps are sensitive to touch. In some arachnids, they squeeze and chew food. In mites, the tips of pedipalps become specialized containers for transfer of sperms. Actually, the tips of these ones, as you can see, this mite. So we have said that in mites, the tips of pedipalps become specialized containers for transfer of sperms. That is during mating. Another characteristic is that the cephalothorax commonly has 8 simple eyes. We have the last characteristics, but this is not the least one. Most arachnids have long beaks for gaseous action, that is internally. Members of this class are carnivorous and are able to paralyze prey using the poison produced from poison claws. So those are the members of the characteristics and its general characteristics. Now we are going to look at another class, which is Insecta. Now we are going, actually this one belongs to all the insects. We can have diagrammatic representation of some of the insects. So as I am going to give the general characteristics of this class, let us try to see if we are able to see or observe these characteristics on our diagrams, which are on our screen. One of the characteristics is that the body is divided into three parts, that is the head, the thorax, and abdomen. Remember, on the arachnid, we have said that the body is not differentiated into that because the head and the thorax are conjoined to form the cephalothorax. But in the case of the insects, the body is divided into three parts, that is, we have the head, the thorax, and abdomen. We have the thorax is made up of three segments with three pair of legs. Some insects have one or two pair of wings on the thorax. Let us have these general characteristics here. So we have said that the thorax is made up of three segments with three pair of legs. The head has one pair of antennae. Another characteristic is that The head has a pair of compound eyes and several simple eyes. We can have our fifth characteristics, whereby we can say the mouth parts consist of the mandibles, the maxillae, and the labium. The mouth parts are modified according to their feeding ambits. Easy, we have got chewing and sucking. The abdomen is made up of 11 or fewer segments with terminal parts modified for reproduction. Actually, what you should know about this kingdom, that it insects, they form half the population of animals on earth. So there are very many insects in this world, and this is just whatever we are seeing from our screen, this is just a representation of some of the insects that we have. These insects belong to actually to different other classes, but now we are going to these are just general insects. Another characteristic is that the abdomen is made up of 11 or fewer segments with terminal parts modified for reproduction. You can have another one next. They breathe through the spiracles. Gaseous exchange is through the tracheal system. Our eighth characteristics of this class is that the insects undergo complete or the incomplete metamorphosis. There are some which undergo complete and others undergo the incomplete metamorphosis. Excretion is through the malpighian tubules, which remove it removes the uric acid. We can have these are not this is not a characteristic, but actually what we have the study of this class, which is the insects, is normally known as the entomology. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity whereby you are required to identify the general characteristics of the arachnids, as we have seen. For more information on this lesson, you can refer to from KLB, secondary biology students book 3. And for this and more, you can contact us by sending us an SMS through this number which is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel and also our Facebook page, which are both Elimu TV, or you tweet us at @ElimuTV_Kenya. Let us subscribe so that we might enjoy this and many more of our biology lessons. You'll be welcome.